Here at Amgen for Cymru, we have a superb collection of the Blatchka class models. It's one of the largest surviving collections of these models within the UK. The Blatchkas were really inspired by the natural world, and particularly marine animals, soft-bodied marine animals. Because if you think back to sort of Victorian period, the colour, the shape, the form, the morphs, much more difficult to preserve. And this is where Leopold Blatchka came up with a fantastic idea of making these things out of glass. In the decorative art industries where they worked in Germany, it was a very competitive field, and so they were looking for options to make some money, basically. And one day, they were apparently given the book by the British naturalist Gosch, and it's said that the plates in this book inspired Leopold to make his first marine models, and from that, the whole industry of making the Blatchka marine animals evolved. Fundamentally, we call these glass models, but they're much more than glass models. They've been made out of many different materials. On top of the glass is the key material, but on top of that are waxes, are wires, are pigments, paints, animal glues, plant resins, a whole raft of materials, because what they tried to explore was how to capture that shape and texture of that animal in life. And you can do that with coloured glasses in a way, but sometimes those colours are too vibrant or not vibrant enough. Sometimes the translucentness of the animal isn't caught in the right way. So they explored all sorts of techniques in trying to get that coloration, layering the glass, putting coatings on the inside, coatings on the outside, a whole raft of techniques. And as they got better and better at making these animals, they got taxonomically more and more correct. From a conservation point of view, caring and looking after these models has quite a lot of complexity. Not least the fact they're made of glass and fragile, but also the fact that a lot of the materials they use, like the animal glues and the plant resins, age and get brittle over time. So things do fall off, and that's going to happen, unfortunately, due to the age of the models and the way they're constructed. You see cracks and things here every so often, and there's numerous repairs and past history to this model, which shows its use over time. But on the other hand, they are remarkably robust. You take this Radiolarian, it's been glued to boards, it's been in many different exhibitions, it's travelled around the place, and yet it's still with us despite all that. This model has even been as far as Australia on tour. This one's much different. As you can see, it's badly damaged, it's losing tentacles, it's had a hard life. For some reason, it's been removed from its base. But the fact this is damaged is actually a really useful model. And if I lift the top bit off, you can see the little paper cone with the little colour stripes on it. And when you put the glass piece back on, what you can suddenly see, although some of the coatings and things have been lost and damaged, you can see there's coatings on the inside of the glass, there's paint on the outside of it. They used all these techniques to try and bring this idea of what this animal looked like in living life.